Everyone, and welcome back to Air on Air Radio. I hope we're live. I assume I am. And I'm just going to go with it. I am joined today by my illustrious guests. Here today with me is Forrest. Forrest, introduce yourself, Forrest.
It's me, Forrest. I'm a big fan of Air on Air. Thanks for having me on. I'm a big fan of it. Thanks for having me.
He's a little nervous. Forrest. But that's okay because I'm also joined by A1 Ulliam McDougall.
Good morning, everyone.
Hello, Ulliam. Now, you've been here for several hours now, haven't you?
Yeah, I've just such a long time in hair and makeup. It's really tough getting ready for radio. People really underestimate it.
Yeah. Oh, well, I appreciate you coming in, Ulliam. It's okay.
Not at all.
Our other guest cancelled, so.
I see.
It's glad to have you here.
Sorry for the confusion this morning.
It's okay. It's fine. We're here. I got you a drink, a beverage.
Thank you very much.
But we're here today on Air on Air. Are you a fan of the show?
I'm a big fan of the show. Been here since the debut.
Nice to meet you, Ulliam. Never been to a bar before. Never been to meet you
Okay, Forrest just tried to say hello to you, Ulliam.
He seemed like he was a bit tired there.
Yeah, that's okay. Are you nervous at all, Forrest? Would you say you're nervous?
I'm a little nervous.
Okay, that's fine. You can be, nervous. Yeah, do you want to take a drink? Yeah, you just chill right there. But here we are, Air on Air. It's great to have you, Ulliam.
Brilliant. Thanks.
I think this is the fifth show we've done.
That'll be the fourth? Wait.
Hey. Thank you very much. Have you ever been here before?
No, I've not. No? I got lost. I went into the main castle and had to ask someone for directions.
Oh, right. Sorry about that.
So it was very nice and showed me that this whole building I didn't even know was here.
Yeah, it was here. Kind of crazy, right?
It's cool. After I went to the other wrong building, because
yeah, I sent you the wrong building.
The cottage is not. I was like, I've been through the whole of the cottage before. I was like, I don't remember seeing the radio studio there. It's not a very big building, so I don't know where they're hiding it.
Well, that's my bad. We've got a couple of listeners on now. Wow, they use my full name on this show. That's crazy.
Really?
Yeah. I probably gave them a full name, to be fair. Mm.
And you got to get the full credit, top billing.
Top billing, yeah. It's my show. this is Air on Air, where we talk about filmmaking, movies, the controversies that happen, and also just Stirling University, Air TV, Air 3, SUDS sometimes, and just how things are going. Film and media course, no other course. I'm not talking about biology, Joseph Glenn.
No other courses deserve it.
Me and Ulliam have known each other how long now?
A couple years, just one year. Yeah.
Wow. Wait, only one year.
Only 1 year.
And yet I feel so.
Oh, it feels like it was. I don't know.
We have spent too much time together, I think. Truly. I don't even remember.
Nothing brings people together like the radio.
I know. We might play our full radio thing.
Oh, we totally should.
We should. No, but I just remember.
Can we get Zoe in real quick just for that, just for the cameo?
Yeah.
And then kick them out.
Zoe, of course, friend of the show.
Of course.
Yeah. Did we meet in radio? Is that it? I feel like I've known you for ages.
We met a little bit before that when there was a fire alarm at Riverside. Because me, Zoe and Anne were walking back from Encanto.
Yeah. I remember that.
We all went to Tesco.
I remember that. Damn. It's just because we've spent so much time editing together. And we've just been in the same space for a while.
Yeah, it's
like
long nights in
no
D4.
No complaints, but there have been some long nights in D4.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Have you seen the new Ant-Man trailer?
I have not.
Have you not seen the new? Right, no. We're going to watch it live. Get it on your phone.
Right, okay.
This is a lot. Breaking news. Wait. No. No.
Breaking news. There we go.
This is Uliam's live reaction to the Ant-Man Quantumania trailer.
Not Ant-Man 3.
No, and it's... I'm going to be honest. I'm interested to see your thoughts because I'm not especially excited.
No? Okay. This is good, just...
Yeah, play it. Let's get copyright striked and play...
Hell yeah.
I mean, we're already playing music, so. I used to ask myself a lot of questions.
You're an ex-con. How are you an Avenger? That doesn't make sense. Oh, Baskin Robbins reference. But everywhere I go, people tell me the same thing. Mm. Thank you, Spider-Man.
People still need help. That's why we made this. This is a... They just joined us. This is a live reaction to the Ant-Man trailer.
I'm such a good reactor. Mm. I can't believe the Fine Brothers turned down my application.
The Quantum Realm. Hear that?
Oh, shit. Talked about that.
Oh, shit. All right, we're buffering. Begins to buffer. Wow.
It's all this quantumness.
But you see what I mean? The immediate vibe is not the same as, I would say, the previous Ant-Mans.
I'll be honest. The Ant-Men, yes. I haven't seen the second one. Here we go. We're back. Now.
I'm looking at Ulin's face right now. Ulin, keep focusing. It's all right. I'm just.
Okay.
He is. I've never seen a man this focused before. I've never seen a man this focused in his life.
There's one thing you've got to respect, it's trailers.
Honestly, this man loves his trailers. He's salivating. I can see it. Dripping out of his mouth. Wow. He's smiling like it's Christmas Day. I think Ulium's in love with Ant-Man.
With Mr. Rudd?
Mr. Rudd!
That is his name. You don't get to laugh at that, Avery. That's his name.
Okay.
The only thing that's going to make me happy is if White Vision plays up.
White Vision?
Yeah, it's the only thing that really could... That, he looked a bit like White Vision there.
Yeah. Wow. Said the title, Ant-Man.
Who is that?
It's Kang. He was the guy in Loki. You haven't seen Loki. Uliam has not seen Loki, folks. So none of that was interesting at all.
I'm not gonna lie. Most of that washed right over me.
Right. Yeah. Right. It doesn't feel like an ant film.
An ant film.
Doesn't feel like Ants, the animated film.
It's not. We haven't quite reached the heights of A Bug's Life, I don't think.
No. But it looks kind of just okay, right?
It really does. And I'm not a fan of all the ones that are like completely CG environments and everything. I don't think it looks that good anymore. They've slipped.
Yeah.
Like we went to see Multiverse of Madness. Mm-hmm. Like a lot of the opening scenes there, I was just like, this just doesn't look very good.
Yeah. Not interesting.
No, it's like a really sort of dull, basic sci-fi kind of setting. Mm-hmm. And it all looks kind of grainy and weird.
So you would rather these practical effects and actually shrink a man down?
Yeah, we have the technology. It's 2022.
It's 2022, and you want to shrink men down.
If you want to phrase it like that.
Yeah, I suppose that is
what I would like to do.
Mm-hmm. Can you hear yourself when you speak?
I can, yeah.
Is it nice?
It's...
There's a little warmth to it.
Yeah, it's kind of surreal, but it's comforting.
That's surreal but comforting. Air on air, folks. You heard it here.
That should be the tagline.
Yeah. It's a little weird one today because it's reading week.
Yeah.
So, you know.
I'm surprised I actually managed to get a seat on the bus.
You got the bus. I got the bus too.
I had to sprint.
Well, thank you very much, Ariam. It means a lot to me, honestly.
I could see it coming. Unfortunately, two people I recognized were on the bus and saw me sprinting for like half a mile.
Close friends?
Not too close.
Acquaintances. That's the worst kind of person. Because if they don't know you at all, it's fine.
Yeah.
You can just... Who gives a shit?
I stepped on the bus and I could hear giggling from the corner. I was like, oh, God.
Ugh. Oh, no. Drink your iron brew.
Thank you.
You're allowed to drink anything you want.
I'm running on empty here, man.
Have you had any breakfast? Oh, I would have got you some. I'm sorry.
No, it's all right. To be honest, it was like when I got the message this morning, I was like, all right, okay, I've got to get there as soon as I can. It wasn't until I left the house. I was like, oh, that's no food. Huh.
I should have got some food. Are you hungry?
No, I'll be all right. I just need the boost of energy.
Just need the energy? Is the iron brew doing it?
Oh, it's doing it.
Yeah. Aaron Air, free iron brew. All right, I told people I would play only Smash Mouth today.
Okay.
So I started by playing my new favorite Smash Mouth song, Pacific Coast Party.
Right, sounds.
And this, ladies and gentlemen, is for those who like it toasty.
Out of recession and oppression, and together they talked and they smoke with the tears because a baby's life has been revoked. The bond is broke, got so choked up and focused on the close up, Mr. Wills, I can't reform. No God like Hocus Pocus, so don't sit back, kick back and watch the world get bushwhacked. News that's in your neighborhood is under attack. Put away the crack before the crack put you away. You need to be there when your baby's old enough to relate.
Wow, what a song.
I like this show better when Chris Pratt was on. Show better when Chris Pratt was on.
All right, Forrest.
Show all better when...
Can we get Chris Pratt back?
Yeah, yeah. Last week, Chris Pratt ran off with Warwick Davis and Steven.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
And formed a jazz band.
I missed the conclusion to that. Did he die?
Yeah.
Did he have a stroke or something?
You're going to need to be more specific. Who had a stroke?
I thought Chris Pratt had a stroke.
Well, Forrest looks like he's shivering right now.
Yeah,
he's kind of sweating.
Really not looking good.
Yeah, I can feel your pulse rattling the table, my man. Yeah, sit on the couch, Forrest. Okay.
Yeah, whenever we lie down.
Yeah. Oh, he's lying down now, and he's just doing cycles in the air. He's just running.
It's not a good sign.
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe Chris Pratt will come back. It was kind of creepy. We had to keep him in a cellar for a couple of weeks. But
yeah, he doesn't give off the best vibes.
Chris Pratt, yeah, I know. He's not my favorite famous Chris.
No, and there's a lot to choose from, so it's.
I can think of four: Pine, mm-hmm. Pratt, Hemsworth, Evans. There's Chris D'Elia, the comedian. Chris DeBur.
Chris Rock.
Chris Rock.
He's also pretty low.
He's, yeah. Who's your favorite Chris?
Who's my favorite Chris? I like Hemsworth. Hemsworth's very funny.
Yeah. Yeah, he's good.
And Evans, actually. I like him in Knives Out a lot.
Knives Out? Have you seen this? Is the second Knives Out out?
I don't think so. I think it's coming out soon-ish. Ooh, cool. I'm very excited for Knives Out 2.
Cool. Imagine if Daniel Craig just becomes like, has another career as a crime fighting.
That would be fun, actually. Different accent every film.
This week, I'm solving mystery. Yeah.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah. Air on Air.
No, that's probably my most excited for film of the year. Yeah. I love the first Knives Out.
I did too. When that come out? 2018?
That was...
Get that up? I'm saying, can we get that up as if I'm not running?
Forrest, you got that, Forrest?
Forrest. That's his... you can hear his legs.
He's unresponsive otherwise, though.
Yeah,
it's a shame.
I think he's actually foaming from the mouth. We should probably call someone, right? I think he'll be fine.
You'll probably be all right.
He's run across the country, off the US before, so...
He's been through worse. He went to Vietnam.
Yeah. This guy's been to Vietnam. So, yeah, I think he'll be okay.
First vet on Air on Air.
I'm a little nervous.
Yeah, me too, Forrest. Me too, Forrest. I'm kind of nervous too. But thanks, thanks for coming on the show anyway. I appreciate that. So, Uliam, are you a listener of Air on Air?
I am. Do you, every week?
Every week? Every, the 4 weeks we've done?
Every single time. Well, especially this one.
You can't fucking escape it this time.
Very tuned in this time. But yeah. I always make time for Air on Air.
Uliam, of course, we have something in common. Mm-hmm. We are both on Air TV committee.
That is true, yes. I'm not as experienced in this regard as you, I'm afraid, but I am.
But
I'm,
you are probably more valuable than me, let's be honest.
Oh, I have my doubts.
I'm the head of web, and you, good sir?
I am head of tech and equipment.
Yeah. Definitely. How are you finding it?
It's good fun so far. I like the committee a lot.
Cool.
It's a good group of us, I think.
It's good being in that room. I find my role is, besides the poster publicity officer, I think mine's probably the most creative role.
I'd say so, yeah.
I get to have the, you know, control just this thing and just design it, which I think is really cool.
Do you have completely just like...
Well, obviously I can't make just like draw dicks everywhere.
I
can't just burn to the ground, but... You know, with the color scheme, with how I want things to lay out, it's kind of just they tell me what info they want on it, and also I can write my own stuff. Like I've written a few things in, and I write promos for everything that goes on. So, like, let's say 1 week last week we had a character workshop, right?
Right, right.
So next week, when the character workshop's published and uploaded onto YouTube, YouTube if you prefer, I will. You know, write little, this week was our character, or like, last week was our character workshop. We did this, don't forget that. And I usually write some stupid, funny thing.
Hell yeah.
Though we are still, I think, on the third page of Google for the website.
Really?
So yeah, our SEO isn't good.
Are there more ATVs?
Yeah, there's quite a few. Oh. There's an ATV, I think they're a TV production company or something.
Oh, I do actually remember the first time I was looking for the Facebook group.
Yeah.
There was like AirTV International or something like that.
Oh, yeah, and then AirTV International.
We're unfortunately not international.
No. Yeah, we're a national. We support the SNP.
we voted yes in 2014.
Yeah. Hang on, Forrest. I think you've got something relevant to say.
I like that ratio now. I like your song, they say. Farewell. This is so new.
Rishi Sunak? Was that Rishi Sunak?
Did you hear that at all?
Folks, I think Forrest Gump supports Rishi Sunak. Forrest Gump, we know three things about Forrest. Mm-hmm. Loves to run.
Right, yeah.
Vietnam.
Mm-hmm. True.
Loves Rishi Sunak.
He is very proud of Vietnam, which...
Oh, he's proud of it?
I think so.
Do you think that explains why he likes Rishi?
It's a bit of a red flag.
Yeah, that is he is holding up a red flag, actually.
Didn't he meet Reagan?
Hey, Forrest, you mean Reagan?
Well, did you?
Yeah, there's a bunch of stuff. Do you want to sound like a really high Ulium, a low Ulium, or like you're really far away?
Being far away sounds pretty fun. Oh, shit. So, I mean, I can.
this is the cellar. Me and Ulium just climbed in the cellar. This is where Chris was. Lots of blood on these walls, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Chris is gone, though. He's
yeah, well, I think work. So, but you can smell him. It smells
good.
Yeah,
it's very pungent odor.
Pungent. What did you say?
It's a fun word.
Now I just want to play D&D. Should be a D&D radio show.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, we can make that happen.
Do you want to just...
We'll think about it in a bit.
All right, okay.
But I want to talk to you about two things today. One is, of course, AirTV. Mm-hmm. The other is this kind of... You've got a bit of a name for yourself now. There's a bit of a legend of Ulium when I think of him.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that true?
I think, well, you've got a mythos about Barra.
Oh, of course. That's been built up.
Yeah. Some people make films called The Pint. Others, you know, are from Barra.
Just by virtue of my birth.
By virtue of your birth. And now you're here.
I have an interesting story to tell.
So Barra, as far as I can understand it, is an island off the west coast of Scotland.
That is true. Mm-hmm.
So I'm correct so far. I'm 100% right so far.
About 5 hours west of...
5 hours?
Yeah.
It's only over the way.
That's what they keep telling me, but...
Do you go by boat or plane?
I went home this weekend and I went by plane.
Ooh, wow.
Mm-hmm. And it's a little easier. It's only an hour by plane.
I imagine you have to fight some kind of serpent.
To get on the plane?
Yeah.
Like, You do have to go like full Indiana Jones. You have to like you have to run for it. It's a seaplane, obviously. Yeah. So it's like sprinting down the Clyde, mm-hmm, jump
mm-hmm.
on.
Mm-hmm. And why were you going home, if you don't mind me asking?
I was going home to look after my wee siblings.
Okay, so you had to go through an Indiana Jones level adventure to get home.
Yeah, that's the kind
to
of
babysit.
That's the kind of parent. Wow. I would be.
Wow, Uliam's commit.
My parents are on holiday, so I had to go and make sure the house wasn't on fire.
Oh no, yes. So, what is life like on Barra? I want to know. Do a tell-all. This is here. Okay. Pretend we're promoting your autobiography. What would it be called, first off? Barra. The Barra.
The Barra boy.
Baron of Barra.
The Baron of Barra. Oh, I could be Baron. What do you need to be a Baron again?
A royalist, I think. A bootlicker. You know what
I mean? I can put that on for a bit.
Yeah.
Just for the title.
So, we're just looking for his boots. First page of your biography, born on Barra. What's it like? What's the life like on Barra?
Well, is there anything specific you'd like to know? Because
I imagine you have to like the quiet.
Yes, it's a big difference. You can like, I don't notice it when I've been in Stirling for a while, but there is just a kind of constant background noise of traffic going and stuff like that. And I was jump 40s, the train goes by every once in a while, but. No, where I am, I'm technically, my house is on the side of the main roads, but main roads are very strong term for what it is.
Oh yeah.
So, past like 11 o'clock, you're probably not getting any traffic, and you can just hear the gentle sound of the waves.
So no nightclubs, that is what I'm hearing.
There are no nightclubs. A lot of gaffs, but no nightclubs.
All right. A lot of pubs.
There are three. Two are right next to each other. And all three are part of hotels. So it's like, there's no standalone pub.
Yeah. Cool. And there's only a co-op.
There's a co-op, and there's like a couple like local grocery shops and stuff like that. One's called The Butcher's, and it doesn't butcher.
It's no? Not got all doesn't butcher?
I don't know why it's still called that.
But would you recommend a visit to Barra? Do you think everyone could learn something?
100%. I think it's a very popular tourist destination for people who are like wanting to holiday within the UK.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's a lot to see there, especially if you're a fan of like outdoorsy kind of holidays and not like a super busy one where you're doing every activity you can think of. It is definitely like a laid back pace of life.
Who do you think earns the most on Barra? Do you have a mayor?
We don't have a mayor. We've got a councillor.
Councillor?
I don't think he gets paid very much, though.
Okay. Who do you think?
One of the hotel owners is a bit of like a hotel baron. Right. So I'm going to... They're the Baron of Barra.
So you need to be doing some usurping, son, if you want to use that title.
I need to get that hotel.
Who owns Barra?
Who owns Barra?
Like, do you have a, like...
Well, because I learned a bit. For a little bit of the summer, I worked in our local, we've got like a local historic culture and heritage centre.
Mm-hmm.
And I worked there for a bit in the summer. And I did learn a bit about this. Because it used to be the clans, Clan McNeil owned Barra, way back when, and then I think when the clans disbanded, it was just like crown/government owned for the most part, with a few pockets of like private lands.
Mm-hmm.
So no, for the most part, it was all private lands because in the 19th century there was like a baron from Aberdeen, or like a lord or something like that, and
we'll say baron.
It could be a baron, yeah. The Baron of Barra.
Let's only say baron from now on.
It's there are no other royals. It's only barons.
Yeah.
Baron Charles.
Baron? Is that his name?
No, no, that's who's in charge of us right now.
Baron Charles
III. Baron Charles III. His name was Baron Gordon.
Gordon?
Gordon of Clooney.
Gordon of Clooney. Damn.
It's from up in Clooney, whatever that is.
Baron Gordon Clooney of Barra. What a life he must have led.
Seriously. He apparently never visited Barra.
Really?
he lived on the East Coast and he didn't give a fuck.
The East Coast?
He lived in Aberdeen. Damn. Aberdeen. Like, most of his land was in Aberdeenshire.
He was an Aberdonian.
He was an Aberdonian.
I've never been to Aberdeen, you?
I'm not. Furthest up that way, I've been is Dundee.
Dundee.
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is fascinating.
It's until last year, maybe 2 years ago, I'd never been to Edinburgh.
Well, me too.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
But it's definitely worse when a Scottish person says
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah, true, true. I haven't been to Aberdeen. I've been to Perth. I haven't been to St Andrews. I've only been to, I could say where I've been, because that would be a much shorter list. I've been to Glasgow, Edinburgh, and Stirling, and Larbert.
Yeah.
You've been to Larbert.
Capital of Scotland.
Home of the Forth Valley Hospital.
Mm. So much more.
Really? Oh, a lot of bowling greens, I guess.
Yeah.
Larbert train station.
They got a play park, I think.
I think they've got internet now.
really? Yeah. They've gone that far?
Yeah.
God, they got it before us.
Do you think I'll ever go back to Larbert?
Well, I won't step off the train there, probably.
Okay.
Unless I have like a heart attack. That might be a reason to go there.
Oh, true.
Well, I'll pass through. I go to Glasgow fairly often. So
yeah, what do you do in Glasgow? Or is that to go to back to Barra?
It's to go back to Barra or to see family. I've got a lot of family in Glasgow.
Do you?
Yeah, that's where most of the Barra folk move to. They're not staying in Barra; they're going to Glasgow.
Wow. Okay. How about another tune?
Another tune sounds good.
All right, this is a question that I think Forrest would have for every one of us.
Remember when you drank my wine? Why can't we be friends? 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 I seen you walking down to Chinatown. I called you, but you did not look around. Yeah, yeah. I pay my money to the welfare line. I seen you standing in it every. As we can live in harmony, yeah, yeah. I kinda like to be the president. Then I could show you how your money's spent. Did I know what I was talking about?
meet you, William. Never been to a bar before. Never been to meet you at a bar before. You and Liam are bothered for you, probably.
I really don't like Forrest doing so well. He's repeating himself.
Yeah, Forrest, you want to go to the hospital, my man? you want to run somewhere? He's off. Hands and feet. He was running four-legged then.
It was surreal to see, to be honest.
Okay. Everybody. I feel the energy is lulling. There's a lull. We're both very tired. Yeah. So we both need a... I don't know. I'm bringing more energy to the table and hoping something comes out. Right. It's lock-in week.
It is. ATV lock-in.
ATV lock-in. What are you making, William?
Me and friend of the show, Zoe Thomas.
Friend of the show!
And you, I think, maybe.
Me, friend of the show!
I'm friend of the show.
I'm a friend of the show. I'm the host.
You're the friendest of
Why can't we be friends of the show?
Oh, All Star was about Air and Air the whole time. That wasn't All Star.
Yeah.
Smash Mouth, that's what I meant
Smash
to say.
Smash Mouth. Listen, William. Fucking goddamn it, tell me right now.
Right.
What are you making?
We're making a film about Joseph Glenn, friend of the show.
Friend of the show.
Eating shoelaces.
Right. Okay. I think there's a bunch of shoelaces. Should we explain the backstory of this fucking...
Sure, it's a story to tell.
So...
Our listeners definitely don't know about this.
Yeah. Last week, I think. Was it last week?
It was
2 weeks ago. It was a 48-hour film challenge.
Yeah, well, weekend before last.
And we made a film involving shoelaces.
Yes, the required prop was a shoelace.
And we had killers. Basically, that was their marker. This serial killer would leave a shoelace mm-hmm. as their mark.
They're calling cards.
And one of the ideas that was pitched was Joseph Glenn eating shoelaces from the show, which I don't know if there's a whole arc in there. Like, does he discover he doesn't like shoelaces?
I think the idea from what Zoe's told me, there is a script. I've not read the script yet. I think the protagonist is the person whose shoelaces are going missing.
Right.
And they discover that it's a rabid Joseph Glenn.
Spoilers. So Joseph Glenn is the protagonist. What does he want? He wants his shoelaces because they're being stolen. What's stopping him? He doesn't understand. There's a mystery. The person who's stealing or thing or entity mm-hmm. is stealing his shoelaces is evasive. Mm-hmm.
The hunt goes on.
And what does he learn? He learns that he should just get Velcro.
That should be the arc. Holy shit.
I'm just obeying the screenwriting rules I learned last week.
Have you ever thought about taking screenwriting?
I do take screenwriting. William, I learned how to do that last week.
Hell yes.
No, man.
Oh, I love Big Stuart.
Beef stew.
I'm not sure if I'm comfortable calling that.
You're calling that. He wants you to call on that, William.
Does he? Is that Let's a request pretend. From Mr. Hepburn himself?
Sure, yeah. You take another sip. I saw you reaching. Fucking just drink. Do ASMR right now. I hate that so much. We just got two more listeners. Keep drinking the iron brew. Got two more listeners.
The ASMR from the iron brew. This is what makes it on YouTube nowadays.
Yeah. We're sellouts. Wait, hang on, let me up your mic sensitivity.
I didn't quite get it right that time.
It's not showing up. You need to do it harder.
I'm doing it as hard as I can.
No. Early, you're not.
What was the problem? It happened the first time.
I know. Jesus Christ. Can't get the brew.
Oh, well. I got a lot of brew there.
Is that your drink of choice?
Not usually, but I do like a better iron brew.
You do love an iron brew, don't you? Is that your favourite can? I got the sugar-free.
To be honest, I don't taste much differences between like extra sugar-free, whatever, so I genuinely don't mind at all which variant I get.
Well, good.
I'm very thankful, Harry.
Yeah, you're welcome, man.
Thank you very much. I needed anything that would give me a boost of energy.
Yeah. Is it giving you a boost? Do you feel like...
It does. I feel a lot better after.
I know. I had one of those shots, those health shots.
Oh, hell
yeah. You can get for £1.05 at Co-op.
Oh, nice.
And it was like, yesterday I had, you could have got the bourbon.
I'm just had a little burp.
You can do it on the mic. Love it. We got two more listeners because you started sipping.
Are you sure?
Yes.
I feel like the burp might be a step too far.
As long as you don't puke, I'm fine.
Well, I can't promise, but I will do my best.
Okay. Yeah, I had one of those health shots. It had like ginseng, which who the fuck knows what that is?
Is it a root? I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
It's an item in Pokemon. that's what I learned.
Yeah, if you give it to a Pikachu, it evolves.
Yeah, that's what I always did when I was younger.
We have one more listener. We've got to keep talking about
ginseng Pokemon.
Ginseng sounds like a Pokemon, actually. Is it a Pokemon?
It should be. Maybe the new one.
I haven't seen
any of the new Pokemon. I try not to spoil myself before a new game comes out.
Yeah. You wanna have that fresh taste. But anyway, exactly. I had this shot and I had the other one yesterday. So there's a green one, there's a yellow one. Okay. Yellow one is like vitamin C. Green one is like fear bowels.
Ah, I see.
The green one tastes nice. The yellow one tastes horrible.
Really?
I think it tastes horrible. Jeez. It's like turmeric. Turmeric.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And vomit.
A little bit of vomit.
Yeah. But you couldn't sip that. It's not enough to sip.
No, you can't.
Yeah, you got it, Sean.
You got to just get it down the hatch.
Yeah, you got to get it down. But I did feel better afterwards.
That's good. I guess that's what you want out of a shot like that.
Have a shot. A health shot. Do you believe? Have you heard of this phenomenon? Juicing?
No.
There's like, it's so. Kind of weird. It's kind of a bit religious. Religious?
Religious.
In America, they have this phenomenon where it's like juicing, where it's a bunch of middle-class white people, white Americans. They're not people. and they believe that, like, as long as they drink a fuck ton of juice, their health problems will be fine.
Oh, okay.
And so you see them on, like, telemarketing channels just drinking so much juice.
Like... Is it like smoothies, like making...
Yeah,
making
it's smoothies, yeah. Juices? Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then they strain it to get the juice. And it's just strange because it's like they act like it's doing them so good, so much good. And it, you know, vitamins, yeah, but the sugars.
Yeah.
You know?
Is it mostly like fruit and veg drinks and stuff like that?
Yeah.
Just like... They're just blending chicken and stuff like that.
Yeah, it's a beef smoothie. Beef stew is just a smoothie.
Why do you think about it? This is like a soup test, like a cereal or soup?
Is cereal... Why have you said that? Is cereal a soup? No. A bowl of cereal, yeah.
Oh, that's true, actually, yeah.
With milk? Is milk... That's horrid. No, because it's like...
If you pour it into your Weetos and the Weetos make the milk chocolate, that's like making it...
You know what I think it is? It's like how a burger is a sandwich.
Yeah.
So it's like you've got this... It's like the realm of the forms. You know Plato and the realm of the forms? Plato believes that there's... We live in a realm of particulars.
Okay.
And there is a realm of absolutes, the realm of the forms, that a perfect version of everything exists. So like the perfect chair exists... up here, and we can't reach it. We live down here where there's imperfect chairs, right?
This one spins.
Never mind, that's fucking gold.
The perfect chair would spin.
We are in the realm of forms right now. So I believe there is a perfect sandwich.
Okay.
And we are just living in a world of particular sandwiches. So you got just burgers, like sandwiches. Yeah, it's kind of like at one of those like birth family history charts.
Oh, okay,
so you got the sandwich at the top and then you go burger, you go, you know, sub, you go
hot dog.
Yeah. So what is the start of soup? So is it soup or is it like a bowl of liquid? You know what I mean? What do you start with? What starts
the
chain?
The origin?
Yeah. I feel like it's gotta be a bowl with a liquid that you use a spoon to eat.
I guess so. I mean, I guess Like, ramen's also a soup, I think.
Yeah.
So that's...
There's probably a name that, like, is in a foreign language for that kind of
meal.
Yeah,
that's true. There'll be something that...
And English that would be it.
Hasn't quite caught up with.
But whatever that is, that's, like, the prime.
I guess maybe it could be, something like, a bowl with a liquid and maybe some, like...
Solid component. Yeah.
Because even if it's blended, it's still got, like, just very small chunks.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
So I think that's our... That's getting closer to our perfect.
Mm-hmm. But is it soup? Because it's... And then we need to decide. So that is the thing. Liquid in a bowl is the thing.
Mm-hmm.
And the soup and cereal are just offshoots of that. So
yeah, I would say so.
I think. I don't think a bowl of cereal is a soup. I think a bowl of cereal is whatever that is, and soup is also what that is.
Right, it's like the grandson of... It's soup's cousin.
Yeah, it's a... It's a cousin to soup.
Brilliant.
Air on Air, filmmaking radio show.
We nailed it.
Well, we just talked about soup for 10 minutes. I am actually very satisfied with that.
I feel
immensely satisfied with the fact that... And we actually have, like, we had, like, quite a few listeners then. We had, like, 8, I think.
This has been your soup etymology lesson of the day.
I know. Soup etymology, yeah.
Tune in tomorrow
for more epistemological discussions. Damn.
I love philosophy. That's the only other valid degree.
What, besides film?
Besides film.
Yeah, shout out to all the doctors out there saving lives. Should we do? I think it's time. I don't think any other radio should do this, but I love this purely because of the song, and you better sing along.
Oh, right. Okay.
And if you know the words at home, sing along. Australian through and through at the Kilted Kangaroo.
You'll be stoked with all the live entertainment 6 nights a week at the Kilted Kangaroo. Kill it. Now enjoy European football every Tuesday and Wednesday night upstairs on the big screen with full commentary and OA for Champions League Lounge. Bonds are days and nights at the Kilted Kangaroo, Upper Craig
ready?
Stirling. Find us on Facebook and Twitter. Come in and
see. Here we go. Australia through and through
at the Kilted Kangaroo.
We have ads. There's 4 Kilted Kangaroo ads. We are a sponsored show.
Oh, brilliant. brilliant.
All right. Welcome back. We're just going to take a moment to refresh.
Okay.
And reflect. My hands are in the air. Uliam's are not, because he doesn't like to reflect. I'm just obsessed, right? This soundboard. Oh, no. Oh! Wow!
Hell yes!
This should be the intro song. My God.
This is like Eden roll call with the characters.
Yeah.
It's like Henry Swindells as the host.
Chris Pratt as Chris Pratt.
Forrest Gump as...
The Running Man. Sitting here eating soup all day. Sitting here eating soup, no way. I love that. That's so good.
Oh
my God. Uliam, your question is cereal a soup?
My answer is no.
That is... the right answer. It is, of course, a cousin
of soup.
Of soup. That's also nice. I imagine they only have this on Barra.
Yeah, we're in the 20s still.
Still in the 20s. Oh.
Oh, you're not giving me the satisfaction.
Dum, dum, bum. Yeah, that's good. Okay, that's not nice.
Oh,
yes, I like that. I wonder if these are 4 other shows. I don't know. Right.
Maybe not the Mission Impossible theme.
Yeah, man. I don't know. Tom Cruise might run a show.
I think Michael Giacchino was commissioned by A3.
Okay.
I don't know if that's Michael Giacchino.
I think it was Hans Zimmer.
Oh, Michael Giacchino was the Incredibles.
I have no idea if Hans Zimmer made that. I assume not.
There's not enough words.
So I've asked a few film students this, and quite a few of them have said yes. Okay. When you hear a song, do you immediately imagine or start imagining a sequence, a film sequence happening to that song? Because I do constantly.
I can't say I have.
I can't help it.
Is it like a very like Baby Driver kind of thing? Yeah.
Or a chase scene or a running scene or just like, you know, the penultimate bit in a Disney original film where they're like walking in the rain.
Right.
And they discover that they should have changed. That kind of thing.
That's really fun.
You hear this, and what do you imagine?
I can see like a very Reservoir Dogs-esque walking scene where we're being introduced to the characters.
Yeah. This is Spike. Spike back in the day was the man.
Oh, fully, yeah.
Yeah.
Will Smith narration.
Will Smith on this show?
I think he was on with Kieran Sweeney, friend of the show.
Yeah, friend of the show, Kieran Sweeney. Congratulations on Media Officer, Kieran Sweeney.
Congratulations.
Happy
birthday. Last week.
Happy birthday, Kieran Sweeney. It's always your birthday on this show. Let's hear it for Kieran Sweeney. I messed that up. You know what I meant.
I was that.
And then there's this. That's kind of like...
Oh, this feels like it ripped off Persona 5.
Yeah. Oh. This is like you've just completed the heist.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, I love that.
This is great. God, I should use those more. And then you've got the... Say a swear word.
Fuck.
That's pretty cool.
Good.
Hello. My name is... Beef Stew.
We have a robot now.
Beef Stew.
Yeah.
Oh no, banana.
That's what I like about having new people on the show. Every time I get to introduce you to the wonders of a sound desk.
It's very fun.
Yeah.
And it always seems to be new ones. There's always something new to discover on there.
Well, after the show, I'll show you the old sound desk, which is massive. I would say it's the entire length of this.
Hell,
you know, this one's pretty compact, right? And you scroll through. The other one, there's no scrolling. It's analog as hell.
Oh, right.
So, like, you got 1,000 buttons. And there's, like, loads of these.
Sort of like the one in D4?
Yes. Yes. Exactly like the one in D4. We all know D4.
We all know D4.
Everybody listening.
Home of the radio. That's not this one.
Smash Mouth's Color of Getting Better.
Friend of the show, Kieran Sweeney, happy birthday. Happy birthday, Kieran.
Here is a song. It's been a while. Take it away.
It's getting better all the time. I used to get mad at my school. The teachers who taught me weren't cool. You're holding me down. Yeah.
That was requested by friend of the show, Kieran Sweeney. Smash Mouth, huh? It's a Smash Mouth day.
It really is.
We were just saying during that little break, I've been watching a lot of Shrek interviews. Mm. Old 2000 Shrek interviews. And it's, I mean, Shrek, I didn't realize how incredible a film Shrek is.
It's genuinely fantastic.
It's clever. It's just really smart film. Yeah. From like the names of characters just to dialogue, just to an interview with Mike Myers. And he most people see Shrek and it's like a funny joke, right? Like, you remember in 2016, all the fucking dank memes.
Yeah, it's been made into a meme.
But you see him like pick apart the character, and I'm probably going to butcher this, but he's like, he starts off Shrek as lonely, and he talks about how loneliness is in each of the four films in different forms.
Mm.
Like the first one is kind of like he's on his own completely, no friends. Second one, he's estranged from his parents-in-law, right. In-laws. Third one's like he's the king. And he's separated from every, you know.
That one happens for some,
and then,
some reason.
And then fourth one, he's like alone from himself.
Right. So from, yeah. Wonderful life kind of.
Who he used to be, yeah. Which I thought was just really cool. Like,
yeah.
I'd love to write, I wish I wrote an essay on Shrek. We don't do essays anymore.
No.
Unless you do advertising.
I'm taking film philosophy, so I'm going to write an essay on something for next week.
Well, hey.
Shrek, there's a lot of philosophy in there. Philosophy of loneliness, that's yeah. the
thing. Yeah, loneliness. And then there's just a lot of archetypes. And sure. he's just like, I love that world. It's such an interesting
really
world.
Well. In retrospect, I'm like, the third one isn't quite as good as I remember it. But I'll always stand up for the fourth film. I really like that
one. I don't think it's terrible.
It's not. It's really not the worst. And it's regardless, they've all got some good guests.
Yeah. And I think in comparison. Yeah, in comparison to like the other ones, it's not as good.
Right, yeah.
They set us a really high standard.
They did.
But like, compared to, I don't know, the Emoji Movie?
Yeah. And even like, even recent, more recent DreamWorks films.
Yeah. It's great.
Really, really great series.
Right, we just lost a listener, so we need to start talking about Juice again.
Oh fuck.
Air 3.
Can we get Athletic Greens to sponsor us?
Athletic Greens.
If you're listening. If you're one of our 7-ish listeners.
6 listeners right now.
6.
But I always imagine there's multiple people listening. Wednesday, right, is a pretty good... If it wasn't Reading Week, it'd be a pretty good place to have a show because Suds is on Tuesdays. A lot of RTV members are in Suds, and they all go out drinking after Suds, and so they're hungover, listening to the show together. Or I always imagine them to be.
I imagine this is a good hangover aid.
Yeah. Is this a good hangover aid? Australia. Is this a good the Kilted Kangaroo? It is. I love it. I'm gonna make an advert for the choir.
Oh, for the. Oh yes.
Yeah. That's quite nice. Ooh, this is kind of like Blade Runner.
Yeah.
It's the opening. Speed.
You can see that.
I am speed.
Oh, it's gotten like
'90s. Yeah.
It's like, it's a bit of a 90s sports film intro.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. His name was Busker Willis. The greatest batter the Washington Cadadias have ever seen.
I love that we both thought baseball.
Yeah, it's yeah. He could swing it. Boy, he could swing it. But one fateful day, one thing happened that changed the course of baseball and Busker's life forever. He met Bugs.
Space Jam 2.
Bunny. Imagine. We've had that one. Oh, I think. Have we had this? Yeah. We should have more. There's about 8 empty spaces for stuff.
Okay. Hey, I like that one. It's my favorite track.
Tell me something.
Like a hot take?
Oh, classic. Classic. Yeah. Do you ever...
What am I like?
This is worse than I thought it would be.
Who's saying that?
Okay, I think he meant the song rather than the...
Oh, right.
The show, I hope. Or Kieran just devastates. Is Kieran not a friend of the show? Wow. He's not a friend of the show, Kieran Sweeney.
He wouldn't
Sweeney.
Betray us like that, would he?
I don't think so. We were filming in here yesterday.
Oh, yeah?
We filmed some of our content in here.
Oh, nice. Oh, I saw some of the pictures on Lewis Franco's stuff.
Yeah. It was a stressful shoot. We had people seeing where you are. For those who don't know, this is film related.
Yeah.
Stirling University film media course. One of the modules is content development and research. It's basically fourth year. It's basically a TV, a serialized TV format creation.
Had to develop and propose.
Exactly, and we are shooting a dating show about musicians, and we shot it here because it's a radio studio,
right?
And so we had people sitting where you are talking to and romancing and playing together. And then had questions on that couch. We had maybe 8 people in this small little room with all our kit. And it's not a big place.
It's really not, no.
For 8 people. I mean, it's reasonably sized.
Is that including crew?
Yeah.
Okay. I guess that's not...
But
not
then
the worst,
all the
but...
bags, all the lighting, all the stuff, and Kieran Sweeney. Though that was good.
His presence kind of just
He was good.
Overwhelms.
But I don't remember my point was. I think I was just telling you about the content.
Mm.
Yeah, we shot in here, and I think it went well. I was on sound. What are you doing for yours?
I'm production manager.
Wow.
Producer boy.
Is that what you want to do?
I had no intent before I started it.
You were thrust into the role.
Thrust into the role, and I'm kind of enjoying it.
Yeah.
I forget how satisfying just like organizing and putting and making sure everything in its correct places is to me. It's a very I don't know, like viscerally satisfying.
Yeah, I bet.
Kind of thing.
Is that why you went for head of tech and equipment as well?
That's why I did.
To organize the cupboard.
I'm so good at that. I definitely have done it at least once.
Okay. We are collaborating on the booking system right now.
Yes.
Let's talk about it.
We should.
So.
And also, if you're listening, Pedro, I'm sorry. I will speak to Kevin soon.
The booking system's fucked.
It seems like it's...
It's been fucked for a while, for many years. And previous committees have not wanted to unfuck it. So we're unfucking the booking system. Currently, if you go on the ATV website, atvstirling.com, there is an option, big old orange button, to book kit. The form you fill in, we have no idea where that goes. You send a request and... Someone gets it, not
someone
us.
Somewhere. Not us. Not the last head of tech, apparently.
Nope. And probably not the one before or George. So we kind of need to make a new system because that one's a tiny bit clunky anyway.
Yeah.
And I don't know. Maybe not a whole database, but we need to figure something out. Because people just keep taking stuff. And there's no logbook of who took things.
Apart from, like, just very informally in the chat.
Yeah, which isn't good, isn't reliable.
It's really not.
And it's led to situations where we've lost things or we've left, you know, SIM cards in bags and we're like, where have this hundreds of pounds worth of equipment gone? And it's like, oh, it's there. Behind a desk. Like we found a slider. We found recently ATV has found loads of equipment under a desk.
Is that where it was?
Yeah.
That where it was found?
Yeah, I think so. Like, you know, in
the
media office, yeah. Like it was really messy and they moved the desks and just found loads of equipment. It's really annoying.
Apparently they've had for like a decade.
Yeah, 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 yeah. If you check out the old ATV trailers, all the equipment's the same. So, which is annoying, but I think this committee's the best one ATV's ever had.
It's definitely the best one I've experienced. I don't think saying much because I've experienced two.
Yeah, but... yeah, me too. I've been on both. I've been on this one. I was on last year's.
Oh yeah, of course.
But we got the Sterling Fund.
We did.
Which for those who don't know is a £5,000.
So just straight grand, isn't it?
Grant. Yeah. And we're going to build a studio. We're going to something similar to this, I think.
Yeah.
They've
even got their logo like.
Yeah, exactly.
Like trying to do.
And I don't know if we know where it's going to be yet. I think there was meetings.
I know Polwarth was in the talks.
Yeah.
But I don't know if that was.
I don't know where in Polwarth. Mm-hmm. Is that? That's not. Polwarth is the accommodation building, right?
Yeah. When it was first mentioned to me, I forgot it was an accommodation building and Google Maps it and was like, wow, why are we getting a studio in Edinburgh? That's very far away. Seems inconvenient. And then more people talked about it and was like, oh, it's just over there.
Yeah.
And that made a lot more sense.
Are those yours?
Those aren't mine. Okay. Those are someone's who worked on the 48 hour.
Oh, Edwin's.
That's right.
Edwin.
That's right. Just taking a quick moment.
Yeah.
Folks, not going anywhere.
Sorry. just had got a message there. So a bit weird that it's in Polwarth because that's going to get knocked down, I bet, in the next decade.
That's true.
You know what I mean?
It is old accommodation. Yeah.
It is old. It's been built. It's 50 years old.
Yeah.
At least.
And that's the work in the sports center's done. The work in the atrium's done.
Yeah. So I fear.
Move to accommodation next.
I fear if we don't build it in Pathfoot or the Cotterill or somewhere, then we're going to build it. It's going to be like, great. A decade's going to pass and then it's going to get demolished.
Yeah.
And then our hard work will be ruined. And inevitably, you know, everything will be demolished.
Of course, yeah.
Of course, like, we can't keep forever, but...
And I guess, like, as long as... if it's there for a while before Polwarth's demolished, at least it'll have set a precedent that Airtv is meant to have a studio.
Yeah.
Where's that... if you're demolishing Polwarth, where's that going to go?
Yeah, you need that. Yeah. And that, yeah. And we hope future committees will be as on the ball.
Yes.
But, like, the media office, we've been there for about 10 years.
Oh, is that all, really?
Well, I don't know actually, because there's posters from 2006, like a 2006 awards thing.
Right. Okay.
And I don't know if they were just not hung up, you know, like some of these on the wall. We're looking at some CDs that are kind of placed in rows on the wall, and you see pictures of those, and they're like they're old.
Yeah.
Because you see even the drawings on the door. Of previous shows.
Yeah, God knows how long they've been there.
Yeah.
You're not going to wash them off.
I know. You take... there's some photos out there I'll show you after this of people who... Actually, one guy who was in choir when I was in first year and he was a fourth year. So that... Yeah, it was at least 3 years ago. Mm-hmm. And, you know, a lot of these are the same. And these CDs are all the same. So, who knows? Who knows? It's weird. It is. I get itchy thinking about a society. You just kind of pass it on, and everyone's just kind of assuming it still exists, and its existence is just kind of floating forwards.
It is. It's there's a lot of trust that goes into passing the torch in committees.
And yeah, it's like, what if someone loses a camera under a desk and we don't find out? You know,
for another 10 years. Yeah.
But I hope. You know, we're going to have a studio no matter what. I just hope it lasts a while.
Yeah, I agree. Good place for making movies for many years to come.
I know. We're going to have a sound booth.
Oh, hell yes.
Because the previous people who were trying to make it bought loads of sound.
The proofing.
Proofing.
Mm-hmm.
Which is pretty bitching.
Bruh.
No, pretty bitchin'.
That's it.
That's the bitchin' noise from now on.
Bitchin' noise.
But I hope it's not in someone's flat. Can you imagine? Oh, you're right, really Gage. You're filming again. He says, eating his bowl of soup.
It was just like the green screen set up right next to his fridge.
Yeah.
That's all about just gonna.
Guys, I left a tie on the door. I've got company around. Can you?
And you just hold off for one day.
Hold off for one day, yeah. I think it's time for another song.
I think we're it's chain time.
Do we do Smash Mouth again?
I mean, you did say it should be. Smash
it is fine, but there's like three good ones.
If that. I'll leave it up to you, but
we haven't had All Star yet.
We haven't. Oh, you gotta save that for the end, though, right?
You're right. Shit.
It's All Star.
Wait, have we had I'm a Believer? I don't think so.
We haven't.
All right. I'm a Believer that we're going to pull through and get a studio.
I thought love was only true in fairy tales. Meant for someone else, but not for me. Love was out to get me. That's the way it seemed. Disappointment haunted all my dreams. And then I saw her face.
We're back in the room. Right, we're back down to four listeners. We gotta do something.
What got us before? ASMR?
It was drinking. Yeah, it was drinking.
I might brew that. I've got some water.
Nice. I pray it is enough.
I can do that. It's satisfying. Like,
I'll do it with you. Hang on, we do it together maybe.
Okay. With a spit tick.
Sorry, three. Your mics are all wet. Not really.
No, we're all good. We're all good. We're professionals.
Sure. Yeah, we are.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, we are.
That was bugging me. Okay, I want to talk about how you came to be in RTV.
Okay.
If you don't mind me asking, it's kind of a thing I ask all my guests, even if they're not in RTV.
They'll find their way.
I got one question for you. How did you join? It's so turned into rap. How did you join ATV?
I joined ATV at the start of last year, which is my third year. Because me and Zoe Thomas, friend of the show, were basically spoke to each other and were like, we are film students. We need to go to the Film Society at least once. So we went, and we went a lot more than once.
Yeah.
The rest is pretty much history. Met a lot of new friends. Said goodbye to a lot of new friends.
Wow. Way to bring the mood down. Lost a lot of friends that day. the shots I took.
The massacre of your TV.
Immortalized them forever.
The great 2021 massacre.
Yeah. Well.
So that's what led me to the Great Society.
It is pretty great, isn't it?
I'm a good time.
I'm glad that we joined now, and because from the sounds of it wasn't very good before.
Well, I think
it was toxic.
And I think in second year it was all online. From the sounds of it, I think it was like, I think they got like one new member.
Damn. Oh, yeah, Callum County.
It was Callum County.
President and friend of the show.
President, yeah, friend of the show.
Gave me this show. Thank you, Callum. Cool. So it's pretty interesting.
Yeah. No, I think we're in a really good place.
We're in like the beginning of greatness.
Yeah.
We're in like the beginning of the drugs film, like before they make the drugs empire, when they're just like beginning to sell and seeing all the benefits, but not the downsides.
Are we about to fall from grace?
I feel like we're gonna have our Icarus moment. Like Packwood's gonna get
it's just like destroyed.
Destroyed. And then we're like
hit by a meteor.
And then one of us is like I remember that day. No, that's not different. I remember that day. No way, yay, yay. No, I can't.
That was it.
I remember that day. No, wait. I remember that day. Aaron Air is the filmmaking show. And it was Air TV on Air 3.
Yeah, it's Air Squared.
I came up with the name literally in 2 seconds.
That's a good job. That's a good name. Everyone remembers it.
Everyone wanted to call it Airbenders, which is also kind of cool.
It's good.
But I feel like you need to have...
We could talk about Avatar.
Yeah. Are we the only air stuff? So it's Air 3, Air TV. Mm-hmm. Is there another air?
I don't think so, because like the other media ones are StarPod and The Brig.
We could have done Airbenders. But I feel like you need more than two.
Yeah. It's...
Yeah.
There was only one in that show, though.
Yeah. Oh.
To be fair...
Well, no, there was Korra as well.
Okay, when you go down to it, eventually.
Eventually there's two. So I think Air on Air is appropriate. Yeah. Okay. Uliam. What's one story? Excuse me, Uliam.
Henry.
Thank you. Nice to be here. Thanks for having me on.
Thanks for having me on.
Thanks for having me on. Forrest? He's...
Wait, no, he's off the hospital, isn't he?
Oh, yeah. Is he... I'll see... Hang on, I'll call him up and see how he's doing.
Yeah, see
if he's... I'll call him up.
See if he's surviving.
I'm a little nervous.
Okay. He's nervous.
Going into...
I like that rush, don't I?
Okay.
I like your show better when Chris Pratt was on.
Oh, well, you could go fuck yourself.
We're not getting Chris Pratt back, all right, Forrest?
We're not... How dare.
Dunk the place up. Really bad. It was...
Yeah.
Let's go back in there.
Yeah, so... Back in the cellar. There's just a lot of feces everywhere.
Yeah.
What can you see?
It looks a little bit like the faint etchings of blood.
Faint etchings of blood. Kind of eggshells. Not sure how Chris Pratt brought those in here.
Yeah, that's definitely contraband.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, definitely contraband. The walls were once kind of white and now they're kind of maroon.
Yeah, just like that. They're just faint burgundy.
Yeah, faint burgundy. He was my favourite member of the Beatles.
Faint burgundy.
Faint burgundy is a good name.
He was the sax player, right?
Yeah. He was faint burgundy, they called him. Couldn't always hear him, but he was there.
He was always there.
Yeah.
He's the new Paul McCartney, isn't he?
yeah. His new album's coming out. What's it called? A little
50 Shades of Purple.
50 Shades of Purple. A little bit of sax. A little bit of sax. Never hurt anyone by Faint Burgundy. All
Let's
right.
Get that on. You can bring
All-Stars
to bring on Faint Burgundy.
Okay, here he goes. He's playing the start of it. That's not a saxophone, it's a trombone. Faint. How dare you?
Faint, what are you doing?
Well, there's only one more Smash Mouth song I think we should play, and then after that we should play some other songs.
Okay.
Well, here is the most well-known Smash Mouth song.
Ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
And all that glitters is gold.
Only shooting stars break the mold. It's a cool place, and they say it gets colder. You're bundled up now, wait till you get older. But the media men beg to differ. Mother hole in the satellite picture. The ice we skate is getting pretty thin. The water's getting warm, so you might as well swim. My world's on fire, how about yours? That's the way I like it, and I'll never get bored. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
But your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
Again, folks,
we're back
again. Uliam, you and I are hungry as fuck.
We are fucking starving.
What are you hoping to eat after this?
I'm kind of feeling a pizza, to be honest. I think
I just wish I could eat some of that Studio Ghibli food.
Me too. Oh, Studio Ghibli food looks so fucking good.
I know. I could never have it.
Me, last year when we had access to the fantastic Riverside Cinema Room, me, Zoe Thomas, friend of the show, and Anne Mitchell, friend of the show. She's in her TV now.
Anne is a friend of the show.
Anne Mitchell, friend of the show. We marathoned a few Ghibli movies, and it was so fucking good.
Is it Ghibli? Ghibli?
I think it's Ghibli, because it's in Japanese, it's Ghibli.
Say that again.
What?
Say that again.
Ghibli.
One more.
Ghibli.
One more. It's three characters. Ghibli.
There you go. Ghibli?
Say it like an anime girl.
No. No, I refuse.
Please. So I want to know who these four listeners are we've had the entire time.
Expose yourselves.
So I think that's, because we've had eight, which is pretty decent. But these four people, I want to know who they are. So if you're out there, four people, and you have either mine or Uliam's contact information, don't leak it. Don't leak it to the public. But give us a quick message. I want to know who you are. Oh, it's a giveaway. We're doing a giveaway. We're giving away Uliam.
Me?
Yeah.
My whole self?
Yeah.
We're giving away the eggs and bacon from Hell's Moving Castle.
Oh, don't remind me of food.
Can we talk about food for a second? Just all right, fine.
I
on my way back from Barry yesterday, I had some time in Glasgow before my bus, so I went to a ramen place and had some chicken karaage ramen.
Have you been there before?
I have. I've been there twice before. I got the tonkotsu, the pork one, like both times before. So I've got to mix it up.
Yeah,
I had the chicken one and it was fucking fantastic.
Yeah, I've had a ramen one time in a bar in Newcastle.
Oh, nice.
It's pretty good. And since then, I've made my own. I make my own.
Really?
It's kind of my Henry's cultural appropriating ramen. This is what I say.
I've got to hear this ramen recipe.
I take a stock cube, beef or chicken, And I put it into water, boiling water. So it's got, let's say, chicken stock.
Okay.
I cook the noodles in the chicken stock. I cook spring onion in the chicken stock.
All right.
I roast some chicken in a pan with some sesame.
Oh, sesame oil?
Sesame oil.
Nice.
And some salt, some pep. Pep. And then kind of fry that off, chop it into little pieces. Put it in the broth.
Nice.
And that's it.
That's it. That's the ramen. I mean, that is ramen.
And then maybe I'll put a bit of curry powder in and give it a bit of spice.
Right, okay. It does deserve a little bit of spice.
But that's it. And I don't care if anyone comes at me saying it's a bad thing.
That's a very simple ramen recipe as far as I'm concerned. As far as I'm aware.
Okay, Uliam is basically Japanese.
No, I'm
so.
Not. Don't say that.
Uliam's the most Japanese guy I know.
You got it, like, sesame oil is pretty authentic, I think.
So yeah, you speak Japanese. You're Japanese.
I speak, is that all it requires?
Yeah, you speak the most Japanese ever.
Ever? Than anyone?
Speak some Japanese right now.
Oh, jeebity.
I don't know what that means.
It's Stadio Ghibli.
Stadio Ghibli.
That's...
Arigato gozaimasu, Studio Ghibli.
You're sounding like you're speaking primordial there.
Sorry, apologies.
Arigato gozaimasu.
Oh, no.
Abra. All right, let's check. I've had a few messages from people.
Oh.
Oh, Ben Watterson.
Yes,
friend of the
Ben.
Show. Kieran Sweeney. Oh, friend of the show. And I don't know if he's a co-host, but he's certainly part of the David Steinbeck experience with Kieran Sweeney. He's involved in that mix.
Oh
somehow.
Yeah, he's there.
He's there, and then Izzy Anderson, who I'm affiliated with contractually, and then have you got anything?
No, nothing.
No?
Well, unless no, these are
no.
Unwanted.
Damn.
No friends of the show are friends of mine apparently. Alone.
Whoops. So there's one person out there who is listening, who hasn't messaged.
Who is it? Reveal yourselves.
I've actually had a friend message me that I used to go to school with. I haven't talked to in a while. They listened to the show.
Really?
Because I put it on my Instagram.
Hell yeah. What were they thinking of it?
It was kind of cryptic. I could read the message if...
if you're all right with doing that, absolutely.
I mean, I'll reread it and see if it's appropriate for... even though at one point, I think, last week we talked about something phallic.
That rings a bell, yeah.
Yeah, a bell end, does it?
Perhaps.
Yeah, they just heard what happened to Warwick and Steve. And they enjoyed it. So,
Those are good guests.
I feel like we get decent viewership on this program.
Oh, doing well, yeah. I wonder how it compares to Air 3's regular
viewership. Yeah, I know. Because we kind of have... I feel like the guests make the show. If it was just me, I don't think I could bring the audience.
Right, I get
it
that.
It takes like a certain man from Barra. A certain Barra spice.
Oh, who might you be
referring to? I don't know, but there's a Japanese, whoever it is.
Allegedly.
Ulian McDougal, allegedly Japanese. That's the title of this episode. Yeah. Oh. How long have you been obsessed with the Japanese?
I object to that phrasing. Okay.
Okay. All right. What would you call it? In love?
I have been learning the Japanese language for about 2 years.
And why?
Because I'm a massive weeb.
Ulian, like, it was giving you a way out. You could be like,
I've got to lay my cards on the table.
But they're so greasy. They're not greasy. These cards are Japanese.
They're pristine.
You haven't taken the packaging off these cards.
Yeah, it's the limited edition.
They're shiny, huh? What if I took a bite out of it? Would you?
I mean, whatever happens, happens.
Ulium is like gearing up to slap me in the face.
That's a reference to a show.
Whatever happens, happens. Mm-hmm. That's like every show. My God. Yeah. Well.
No, for those of you that don't know, Stirling University offers online Japanese classes in the evenings.
Eh? Sorry.
Don't say it.
Couldn't resist. How should I say it, Japanese man?
So I'm not going to respond. I'm not going to answer that. They do online classes. They used to not be online, but I never got to go to any of them, unfortunately.
Are you in person now?
I think they're going to be in person next semester, but they're online now. Still.
Have you talked with any more Japanese people? I remember you telling me once that you'd conversated.
Yeah, the tutor who is fantastic, she puts on joint classes with schools from Japan and universities. So I've spoken with some Japanese students from there. That's a good time.
Did you ask them what anime they had watched?
Usually they ask me, so which is, I'm glad, it breaks the ice.
Nice. Do you find a lot of people watch it?
Turns out, basically, yeah. Like, all the university students I've spoken to, fully, they're almost immediately, the question is, do you watch anime?
Yeah. No, okay, Ulium. Because I think every university student that learns Japanese is learning it because they watched.
Oh, yeah, almost. I have met one exception, and it's because their girlfriend's Japanese, which is... objectively, a much better reason to learn Japanese or any other foreign language. Almost everyone in there just a
Week. I mean, good on you for bettering yourself and learning another language, but
thank you.
But you disgust me. No, that's okay. That's cool though. I can speak a bit of French, a bit of German.
Hmm.
I've always wanted to learn Spanish. I should learn Chinese because they'll take over the world soon.
I was about to get cancelled.
We're off the air. No.
Xi Jinping himself is...
All right. I'm going to check. You talk about some... You do a quick monologue.
Okay.
And I'll see if there's any more Smash Mouth songs.
There's got to be at least one more, right? They're whole bands. You could do the Backstreet Boys. They're basically Smash Mouth.
Shut your goddamn mouth, you... Sorry, I just beat up Ulium. You get back in that cellar.
Free me.
I'm not letting you out. I'm not letting you out.
Let me back in.
What's really close to Smash Mouth? It's basically the same.
Tap lips. Smash Mouth, tap lips.
Tap lips.
Punch. Punch.
Punch face.
Punch, yeah.
Gob.
Punch gob.
Punch gob.
Punch gob. All right, I'm putting this one up. I've never heard of it. If it's crap, I'm sorry. But take it away, Smash.
Hey, so you wanna play? game's on fire, but we don't play the same game. You'll see I'm greedy for speed, and neutral means nothing to me. So if that's your desire, we'll get along famously. But one thing I like to leave, I lie to my people before the motor starts. I go so fast that I could never stop. Look under the hood, but you don't know what I got. I'm a moving violation, baby. Hot, 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 hot highway, that's my scene.
Back for the final little portion of RTV. Ulian, who's your favourite member of RTV?
My favourite member of
RTV? We're not in RTV, so this is Air on Air. RTV on Air 3. Ulian, who's your favourite member of RTV?
My favourite member of RTV.
You can't say yourself, and you can't say me.
Okay. Oh, yeah, we're... I wasn't going to, but... don't fly yourself.
All right, fine. You can say me if you want to.
Can I give you a top three? Because there's so many to choose from.
Okay.
Well, it's got to be no particular order. The legend himself has to...
Right.
Wow. If it's not in your top three, then...
Okay, yeah.
Right, you're a runner-up, okay? How's that? How's that?
How many people are on RTV? Like 40?
I think, no, we have 50.
Oh, we have 50?
We have 50 members.
He's in my top 50.
Isn't he? Good.
Okay, sorry.
Gotta get Joseph Glenn in there. He's an amazing actor. Very talented performer. Mm-hmm. Ian Bayfield, the man, the myth, the legend.
Is it Bayfield?
It's Bayfield. Or is it Bainfield? Who knows? I couldn't...
I don't.
It's Bayfield.
And?
I'm doing you a solid here, Ian. You'd be grateful. I think I just have a top two, actually.
Wow! Zoe? Zoe's not in there? Jeez!
Wow. Who else is there?
Kieran Sweeney's my favourite.
He is the media officer. Kieran's pretty good.
Kieran's great. He's, I think, one of the reasons the committee's so good. He's just on it.
He is, really. He's doing a lot for us.
Yeah, County's great. You said Bainfield.
Bainfield. That's it. That's the whole committee. That's everyone.
Anne's cool.
Anne's nice.
Woohoo!
Look.
Yeah.
Me and Anne have lived together for 3 years, so she's like, no, RTV member is not how I classify her.
Okay, right. And she's just nice.
She's just nice.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's all she gets.
Well, this has been recorded, so I'll make sure to send that to her.
Yeah, like, she can just deal with it.
Wow. Frosty. Damn. Yeah. Okay. Ulian, this is the part of the show where I have to give you a compliment.
Oh. Do I deserve one after all that?
Yeah, actually, never mind. You're in my top 49 of NTV.
Who's 50?
I think we all know who's 50. Yeah. Okay.
I didn't realize it was that bad. Heavy, I
You sarcastic. You're really good at sarcasm.
Am I? Yeah. I don't feel good at it. I don't feel good about it.
I think you're very funny. You're great. You're great to have a conversation with him. Like you're very easy to talk to.
I appreciate that.
Yeah. Except when you're roasting at me.
It's just too easy, though, isn't it?
Oh, I will cry on air.
On air.
Leave me my second.
I'm on the ball today.
Yeah.
Somehow. I don't feel conscious.
But... yeah. You're on your balls? That sounds uncomfortable.
Are we not? No, never mind.
You know what I am weirded out by, right? Mm-hmm. So the show exactly after the show is the film and TV hour.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is that a coincidence or...?
I don't know.
Is that deliberate?
But I hope whoever runs that show does a far better job talking about films than we do. Because
we talked about
Ant-Man.
A film. We watched the Ant-Man trailer. We got a live reaction.
Forrest Gump was here. He's been in a film.
Yep. He was famously.
He is a film.
One film.
He is a film. So that's two films.
Uh-huh. We mentioned Shrek.
We mentioned Shrek. We mentioned four. Four, okay. We'll count the anthology. So that's what? Six?
That makes it six films.
That's, I think, a pretty amazing amount, if you ask me.
Very briefly, Knives Out and Knives Out 2.
William, I don't know what I was talking about.
We're so good at this.
And we talked about Air TV a bunch of times. Yeah. And Air 3.
And Avatar The Last Airbender for like a wee bit. That's
and content development. Yeah. And we still have 20 minutes left.
Oh. How many more movies can we fit in? We talked about Speed for like a second.
Speed, yeah. If you could make a movie, what would you
Baby Driver? Well, if I could make a movie.
Yeah, like, if you... Ooh. I don't know what you want to be or what you want to do, William, but right now we're making content. So I want to know, what is your dream...
My dream content.
Your dream content.
I'm not sure, to be honest.
You burp on the mic.
There we go. Are you happy now? It happens.
Guys, William. I think it's time.
G'day. Book now to have a Kilted Kangaroo Christmas this year with 2 3-course meals from $30.95. Or why not book into one of our party nights that includes a 3-course meal, magic, live band and DJ till 2 a.m. You even get a special gift from me from down under. The Kilted Kangaroo, Upper Craig Stirling. For more info, see KiltedKangaroo.com.
Australian through and through at the Kilted Kangaroo.
Thank you to the Kilted Kangaroo for sponsoring us and Ulian's burps. Every time Ulian burps, we have to play that song.
Oh, I can run with this.
I can play all four at once.
What do you call a stray?
Oh, my God, this is awful. Jesus. We are going to get so much money. This is horrendous. Can you even hear me and Ulium? I don't know. Let us know. Right. The Kilted Kangaroo. Three of them played in time.
That was...
which is kind of impressive.
And it was also horrifying.
I know. I kind of want to do it again, though. Dimension. Next time, I'm just going to press all of them at once.
Every button is just the ads.
Oh, just the ads. Yeah. I want that money.
Cash money.
But that's what happens every time Ulium burps. No, that's what happens if Ulium doesn't burp into the mic from now on.
Oh, okay. If I'm polite.
If you're polite, don't... we want the truth.
We want the hot takes.
The doss. The doss or the goss?
The goss.
I do apologize. Ulium said the goss, which of course means Gosling.
Yeah.
What were
Ryan
we talking
Gosling
about?
With us today? Can we get
Ryan? He's just staring at me with his shirt off. He's got abs. I feel like Emma Stone.
Hmm. He's going to be, for another movie, he's going to be Ken in the Barbie movie.
Yeah. Do you want to say something about that, Ryan?
No, nothing.
Wow. He's almost like a lifelike Ken doll, not saying anything. Yeah.
Bit rude, but he must be method acting.
Yeah, I think he is, yeah. Oh, and that was Ryan Gosling. Thank you. Ryan Gosling. Thanks for the goz. That was the goz, everybody.
We got the goz.
What were we talking about? Films.
Killed kangaroo.
Burping. Mm-hmm. If you were to make a film.
Ah, yes, that was it. To be honest, I don't know if I've got a solid, like, fully constructed dream project in my mind. I'm someone who's very happy. Like, I'm very happy to work on other people's projects and put my stamp on them through that way. But
as production manager,
manager, of course. Or I like
editing as well. What? Bit louder for people in the back.
What was that one?
That was the voice disguiser like they do on like BBC documentaries when like they're all in dark and you just see their outline.
I didn't kill him. I didn't. What?
Sorry, swallowed a couple of shrimp there. Yeah.
Oh, I'm so hungry.
I'm hungry. Also, really needed the toilet. Yeah. There's not a toilet here.
Is there not?
No. I would have gone already. Usually, we go in the bushes outside. Shout out to the bushes.
Hell yeah, bushes.
Bushes.
Go.
We love them.
Love a good bush.
Love a good trim on that bush. there's a bunch of cups we could pee into, but
think that the toilets in the atrium are probably close enough.
I think it's the accommodation building.
Yeah, we could break into like Jupiter Court.
Jupiter Court. Get your fucking rocket boots on.
That's what they're gonna replace Paul Worth with.
Yeah.
In 10 years, Jupiter Court will be right next to Jupiter Court.
Or you could just run into a tree over there and have a quick tinkle.
Run into it, like pass out and then piss yourself.
Dude, don't make me laugh. I'm gonna pee. Ow, that hurt. Yes, you could pass out and piss yourself.
In our last 10 minutes, my goal is to make Henry Swindell's piss on camera.
No, piss on camera. Get me a camera and I'll piss on it.
Piss on the camera, but you'll do it on air.
Yeah, on air. Jesus Christ, it's getting Inception levels of. Yeah.
Have you enjoyed? That's another movie we've mentioned.
We should get paid every time.
Christopher Nolan, we just advertised your movie from a decade ago.
Yeah.
Give money.
I think we've got. I think Christopher sent us an advert.
Has he?
Us.
Was Inception sponsored by the Killer Kangaroo?
Nope.
Oh. I think the sound desk answered that.
Thanks for the clarification.
Didn't even press that. That's crazy.
I wonder if the Killed Kangaroo was even around when Inception came out. So long ago.
Do you like Killed Kangaroo? We can't say anything bad on the air.
I haven't been to Killed Kangaroo very often, but I've enjoyed the times I've been there.
I remember you telling me once that you drank like. I remember this now.
I was very ill when you. No, I wasn't. I was a little ill when you brought it up, so I forgot what it was. But I remember now. It's when we went to Meraki, the cocktail place.
Yes. You had a weird unicorn thing.
Yeah, it was a cotton candy martini or something like that.
Cotton candy martini. Who are you, Julian McDougall? From Barra, we only ate mutton. And now here you
it's
are.
Only mutton and dark fruits.
Mutton is. Mutton and dark fruits. God damn. Wow.
I said I drank it. I can't remember if I said I enjoyed it because I don't think you did.
Or you might have been so drunk. I don't remember. There was something about it.
I probably wasn't very drunk.
That means you have to try it again.
I could do that again, yeah.
And if it's bad, then it's just a wasted time.
Are you social at Meraki? Cocktail place?
Cocktail? Cocks?
Tingle?
Tails? Places?
Tingle?
Tingle? I'd be down. We could do it. Talk to Cameron.
Yes.
Yes.
Shout out to Cameron, friend of the show.
Friend of the show, Cameron Johnson, head of events.
Events man, yeah. Mr. Event.
I want to change my title to head of website development.
Head of
web? I ain't Spider-Man.
Yeah, are you getting too much hit from the spiders?
Yeah. All the arachnids out there, fuck you.
All the arachnids and the arachnophobes.
Yeah, both of them. I hate you both.
Yeah. Just get used to spiders. Come on.
Yeah.
They're fine.
I'm tired of having to pick. All my life, I've been picking up spiders out of my sister's room, my mum's room, and taking them outside. When there's a spider in my room, I let that boy be.
He's just looking around.
He ain't going in my mouth.
Yeah,
I'm a bigger predator than him.
Exactly.
Or her. Or them.
Yeah. Spiders.
Spiders. So, you know.
It can be fine. For me, back home, back in the wee island.
Where, sorry?
So, uh-huh. What?
Where?
Huh?
Where?
Where? Where I'm from.
Yeah, where are you from?
I'm from
Barra. Hang on, I think I can zoom in on Barra, actually.
Oh, can you? Oh, yes, on the map. Have we got any listeners from Barra? Oh, no, is it gone? Is it not there?
Oh, it doesn't exist.
No, all the Western Isles were wiped from the face of Scotland.
Yeah. Yeah, we have.
That's rude, actually. Yeah. That might be discrimination.
We only have listeners from the United Kingdom. Strange.
Hmm. I wonder why we don't have any from, like...
The Congo.
Yeah.
Why won't you listen to us from the Congo?
No one from the States? Come on.
Yeah. Right, William. You can pick our last song. We're not going yet. We've still got a couple of minutes. But...
Oh, okay. So I'm just picking it in advance.
Any song? The end of... Okay, so it's your life's just ended.
My life's right? ended.
Or your movie's just ended.
Okay.
And you can pick one song to play in the credits.
Oh, that's a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good.
Do you want?
Can be Japanese if you want.
Have you got access? You got just like full access to anything on Spotify?
Yeah.
Do you wanna throw some traditional, some fiddle music?
Oh, violin music, you said?
No. Well, and I said fiddle, I think.
Let me play you the world's smallest violin real quick.
It's a small fiddle.
Smallest
fiddle is the phrase, okay?
Don't do this.
No.
No.
We're doing this, okay?
It's called... It's a violin.
It's a fiddle.
All my life. Let me fiddle with this. Let me fiddle with this real quick.
It's a fiddle if you're playing trad music or if it's a smallest
fiddle
one in the world.
Fiddle is funny. Fiddle is funnier.
Yeah.
But violin is proper.
That's cultural appropriation.
Good. I'm taking it. I'm using it. I'm fiddling with it. Well, what would you call a viola then? A fiddler.
Viola are different. We don't,
a fedora?
We don't,
huh? You're going to call it?
Why are you playing a viola in my vicinity?
Why are you playing a fedora in my vicinity?
are you a nice guy, Henry?
I ain't answering that question. I'm a sound guy, huh?
I'm a sound guy. Oh, it works on so many levels.
Yeah.
It's very, very clever.
Two.
Yeah, at least.
Me and Uliam have been fighting about this. We should have been fighting about it the entire time.
Yeah, I can't believe
it's kind of the one big conflict in our relationship.
Yeah. It's what will lead to the divorce.
You can have the kids. Because I know you'll...
As long as I get the fiddle.
As you get to fiddle?
As long as I get the fiddle.
Oh, right. I thought you said get to fiddle.
No.
Actually, I'm going to have the kids because that was a scary comment.
Get the fiddle. Uh-huh. You can have your fucking violin around.
Yeah, my violence, huh?
Your violence. Right, no, maybe I should get the kids.
No. You're going to fiddle. I'm going to commit violence. Yeah. Maybe we shouldn't. Ken? Ryan, you want them?
Ryan, want the kids.
He's not saying no, so you can have them.
Yeah, silence is a yes, generally, right?
No one, before meeting you, no one ever called it a fiddle before.
I know many people who would call it a fiddle. It's so many people on Barra.
I know one, and they're wrong, and it's you.
Be proud of that one.
Hmm?
Be proud of that one.
It's one of my best, yeah.
What, really?
Yeah.
That's a shame.
Wow. Look at Uliam clutching.
I'm clutching my pearls.
Why? Nice pearls, by the way. I didn't bring it up, but nice pearls.
Thank you.
They look like geckos.
Oh, yeah, these pearls.
Yeah. They're
from Lanzarote.
The pearl and the swirl. That's me and you, buddy.
Yeah. Oh, which one's which? Well, I guess I'm the swirl by default.
Why are you a swirl by default?
Because I've got the swirl.
Am I the gecko then?
I think you're the pearl.
He brought it back. He can roast you, buddy. He's charming, you know? What a rascal.
Oh, you're too kind. Songs with violins.
I'm going to do a violin cover
of
maybe...
Is there a violin cover of a Smash Mouth song? I keep calling them All-Star.
Smash Mouth.
No, I don't think so.
No. You could be the first.
Is there a fiddle cover of Smash Mouth?
Oh, you... If there is, this is how we decide.
I don't think so.
No?
I don't think
so. That was a long pause, Henry. Are you trying to hide something from me?
No, I'm pretty confident that there isn't one.
Okay, I'll take your word for it this time.
Yeah, I can't see any. Yeah, I can't see any.
That's a real Thank shame.
God. Should we just put on some a violin? Violin cover. Cover. I probably should have been asking you about. I actually do already know all about your backstory because we did an expose on you.
You did that investigative journalism.
Yeah, running up that hill. All of me can't help falling in love.
What if it's something from the Shrek soundtrack? It's becoming. Is a Hallelujah violin cover?
Shrek. Holding out for a hero.
Oh yes, let's fucking go.
Okay.
I mean, you just play that anyway.
All right. Or Fairy Tale from Shrek.
Oh, that's pretty good.
All right. Thank you for watching our show. It's been an absolute pleasure. Tune in next week for more Goofs and Gaffs. Ulium, thank you for coming.
Thank you very much for having me on.
Hope you enjoyed it.
I've greatly enjoyed myself.
And this is Fairy Tale. See you next week.